In a previous video, we learned how to set up an analysis and what the different analysis syntax means. In this video, we're going to talk about the two options we have for outputting to an attribute. My first variable, the total flow, I would like to keep the history on. In that case, I need to map it to a pi point. I can click on map, and I can make it a new attribute. And here I can see I can save the output history. I'll keep that as yes. And I'm going to have my new attribute called total flow last hour. Here I can define a value type. Double is equivalent to my float 64. That should be good in this case. I'll hit OK. I'll map the overflow variable to another attribute, but in this case I won't save the output history, in which case I'll be using the analysis data reference. I'll check now. I will call it the total flow last hour flag. I also know this will only be a 1 or a 0. So I'll change this to Boolean. And hit OK. To learn about the differences between the analysis data reference and a pi point attribute, please take a look at the following KB article. We won't go into the specifics here, but this article is available online, and I will put the link in the description. I would like to put out a word of caution. We've seen many cases where users will output to an attribute of type none. This is an incorrect design and really will have repercussions on your system. Please make sure that you're using the analysis data reference or outputting to a pi point attribute in order to make sure that your AF server and SQL server function as optimally as possible. At this point, let's check in and save our work and also create the pi point attribute and see how our analysis is running. I'll go to the top and click check in. And we can see all the edits that I've made. I'll click check in. And we can see that the analysis is starting up. And when I see the green check mark, that means the analysis has started and is collecting data. In later videos, we'll talk about the different icons that accompany analyses and what they mean. We'll discuss scheduling options, as well as how to deal with future data.